There certainly is, and knowing is half the battle. Thank you so much for joining us. We're going to have open phones in the third hour. There is a lot of news that we haven't even gotten to yet in detail. Police overwhelmingly reject AR-15 cop-killer ammo ban. It's offensive and disgusting that they are using officer safety as a guise to further infringe the rights of people. Police won. We've got some other good news I'll get into. McDonald's new drinking policy will only use sprays without antibiotics. Some bad news. Congress sends Homeland Security bill to Obama without conditions, meaning Obama will now finally open the border. That's a blank check to do it from Congress without voting. Democrats when they're all part of it. Here's the article from 2 years ago. Paul Watson, ex-Treasury official, Obama could use debt crisis to seize total power. Other words, you can go read the subsections of that. That dovetails with a new article today. Bernanke wants the U.S. president to declare economic emergencies, close quote, future crisis. The president should get the power to declare economic emergency. See, they already have it on paper. Now they're selling it as if, oh, we need it. Oh, we need it as a spy to keep you safe. After it's already on the books. The president should get the power to declare economic emergencies along the lines to declare war, according to Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke yesterday. The president should get the power to declare economic emergencies along the lines of declaring war, said former Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke on Monday. We need to get Paul Watson or Adon Salazar or somebody who kidnapped guys from Kurt Nemo or killed Thalen over at Red Cross to go back to the last few executive orders from 2.5 years ago. Directive gives President power to declare emergency for any crisis, including economic. We have a new article out tying it into that, showing how they're now moving to sell. And you notice the season on guns, on ammo, on borders, on war, on security, on spying, on energy, on every subject. It's centralized. Outside Congress, the president, and the bureaucracy of Congress are signing on. It's not a plan. And with it comes false flag terror. There's an article on InfoWars.com. I should send out to everybody you know. Nations all over the world confess to carrying out false flag terrorism. 50 plus links to mainstream news, not theory, not fact, because believe me, this is the next phase. They're training their main enemy, returning veterans, gun owners, and things like that. You can see the writing on the wall. An idiot could see this. And now, that brings me to our guest. A very intelligent man, not an idiot. But like most of us, believing that other people in government corporations are like us, not corrupt. Wolfgang Helbig moved here when he was young. cybersecurity for major universities. His system became one of the most dominant after the tragedy of Columbine. He's been on Good Morning America, Big Show, CNN, you name it. And then he began to investigate Sandy Hook, and it just didn't make sense. He even gave money to Sandy Hook. I'm kind of recapping what he's broken down before. He was the National Executive Director of the National Institute for School Workplace Safety. Say, how dare you kill these guys? Somebody uses a baseball battery. somebody runs over somebody with a Ford truck, you don't blame Ford. You blame who wields it. Look at this article on InfoWars.com. 6-year-old child suspended for making a bad shape with beans. Child first undergo re-education. I'm not kidding. What is it? It means to be dead. Death education. I'm linking mass in the suicide. I want to add to this excellent article by Steve Watson, the image of Obama 2 weeks ago doing a selfie, aiming his hand as a gun.
So they were turning off the
things and blamed it on political enemies. I don't know exactly what happened at the Holly bombardment, but I know the owners are now, brother, who they hunted down and killed. Was in a CIA funded program out of Georgetown infiltrating Al Qaeda groups in Chechnya. And 2 years before the Boston bombing, the Russians blew his cover. The FBI lied and said they never heard of him. They now chased down the other brother and, of course, tried to kill him, but that failed. So now Stars and Stripes and Sarno's lawyer admits he carried out Boston bombing. Wow, so the lawyer comes out and says, oh, he did it. It was him. Judy Clark says, oh, the lawyer's like that. Isn't that nice? He pleads not guilty, but she says it was him. Well, I know one thing. None of that story. Seen this over and over again. False flags don't just happen at the start of the Running Man in fiction movies. They are the bread and butter of totalitarian elements within government. And who can deny it's going in a totalitarian direction that is all America? It's a tiny group. It hurts them as well. They are of their feather. Birds of a feather flock of them. Their father, the devil, I should say. Back to Wolfgang W. Havoc, I want to open the phones up specifically for your questions or comments. I don't have time for diatribes, but not a bunch of name calling against people that say Sandy was happening, to say it didn't. Serious questions. I don't hear from you. I'm not admonishing the general audience, you know, some of the trolls out there. I don't want to attack some of the that opens some dangerous doors. I don't want to attack Havoc. Can bring up any questions or comments. You can disagree with him or agree with him or add points. Here's the toll-free number, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. If we've seen false flags over and over again, and then you've got all these anomalies and clear loop tapes and clear blue screen, green screens, I mean, they really screwed up. CNN screwed up during the Gulf War with fake green screen stuff. It's blue screen in that case. Chroma key. You get a pink screen if you wanted to. Just color something blue and mint green. And, you know, fake scud attacks that are admitted. So, it had all the signs to how they were so ready that day, how they capitalized on how they rolled out all these groups. You know the Aurora shooters. They're real shooters. They're real people that go in and shoot folks up. They're crazy people. It's happened before, but under on record, the Aurora shooter under the top psychiatrist who headed up the psychiatric department for the entire Air Force command of over 7 bases in Kentucky. She's sent there. He's in a secret government brain DARPA interface program. His dad's a top scientist. He's given hundreds of thousands of dollars for the government. Drugged in the parking lot saying he didn't do it. Tells people in jail, drugged, I didn't do it. Then they come out and say, oh, he wasn't with people at the jail where they could hear him, and it turned out he was. So, I mean, I've just seen this over and over again. Shooter James Holmes in DARPA, Weird Science, the article by Kurt Nevin. He folks that can grab me up, since they drug me up, dump me out of the parking lot after they carry out a shooting. And I think that I'd done the shooting, they could do it to you. I mean, you can use somebody on PCP, LSD, this is from the 60s and 70s. They got stuff now. Amnesics they can give you. It is beyond the Manchurian Candidate. In fact, 25 years ago, going back to our guest, they had rubble brain chips in rats. They could send them in to rubble after earthquake. And they had rubble settings in humane. So they keep all that stuff on the L. Like a remote control. how advanced all this is. And I'm not saying that happened at Sandy Hook. I'm saying it was a drill, a giant piece of...